Good morning, students. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about the information retrieval systems. Now we are going to discuss in detail about the cookies in PHP. What is a cookie? A cookie is used for storing the information. It is stored in the hard disk. A cookie, what is a cookie? We will discuss in detail. Unlike normal variables, cookies are used for storing the data, as I said. So the cookie data can be maintained for a long time in a browser, even after you close the browser. So it is stored in the history of the browser. That is what we have searched, that history we will find, no? So that is stored in the cookie memory. That is, cookie is stored in the hard disk of a particular system. So it is stored for a very long time. Data stored in cookies can accessed in other pages as well. Therefore, you can use cookie to transfer small amount of data between different pages in a website. So cookies are used for storing the data. Cookies are stored on the browser level. Therefore, when a cookie is created on one browser, it can be accessed on the same browser only. So based on the browser, suppose if you use an Internet Explorer, that browser has some memory to store the data in the cookie. Similarly, if you go for Google Chrome, so it uses a separate cookie. So it can be used only in the same browser. PHP provides various methods, how to set a cookie, delete a cookie, modify a cookie. So PHP provides set cookie. Now each function we will discuss in detail. PHP provides set cookie function to create or delete a cookie. Data stored in the cookie can be accessed by $_cookie, super global variable. So super global variable is actually $cookie. Dollar, you know very well, if you want to say the value, you are using dollar. We use ampersand, no? Likewise, here we use what? Dollar. Then example, we can use, we use cookies to remember login username and password in a website. So the example, if you ask save, it will ask, no, in the browser. So the username and password are save. Then what we will do is never, like that it will ask you want to save or never give. So what you will give is, if you are giving a bank username, password and all, you will say never. Then if you want to use only in your system, your mobile means, then it will stored in the cookie. It will be stored in the cookie. Mainly it is used for storing the username and password, so that you cannot type again and again. You are going to the same login. Then cookies are also used to store user preference, such as website language or color or theme. For an example, user can be asked to select a color theme of the website, the website layout. Then we will set the background, no, that color background, everything that is stored in the cookie. And then we can store the cookies user preference. Most of the advertisement platforms access user cookies data. Example, Google, Amazon, these advertisement and all, it will store your information, and again it will tell your already available data, some remembering things that will be done with the help of a cookie, like a calendar. So all these things we can do with the help of a cookie. Then reminders. Then how it works? When a user fetch a web page within a browser, some cookies can be created and stored on that browser by PHP. Now each time when the user requests a page with the same browser, it will send to the cookie. Therefore, based on cookie data available, some information can be sent to the user. This special information can be advertisement, user language or color preference or remembering using login and password. So when you go to some website, in the side, in the right hand corner or left hand corner, we will see some advertisements. All these are cookie information. Then PHP provides, now we will discuss what are the functions that is used, what is the syntax for that. PHP provides set cookie function to set a cookie. How can you assign a cookie in your website? So if you are designing a website using PHP and HTML, we can set a cookie to store our information, the browser information, the user information, then you can give it as a reminder to them. This function can take up to 6 arguments. This function should be called before the tag. One PHP set cookie can store single piece of information. So if you want more information, more cookie can be used. Therefore, per information, only one cookie can be used. Therefore, you need to call same function multiple times to store multiple data. Set cookie name, value, expiry date, path, domain, then secure HTTP only. All these are 6 arguments or parameters. What is the name of the cookie? What is the value of the cookie? What is the expiry date? What is the path? Then domain, secure, and HTTP only. Even if you are not, it's not compulsory that all the five parameters should be required. Here totally how many parameters are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 parameters are used here. 7 parameters are not compulsory. So here what is very important is name of the cookie and what is the value of the cookie. Suppose I want to store the mobile number, this is a mobile number. Then the time zone means current system time will be taken, the expiry path. Then what is the path? 86400 × 30. So for one day you want to store, within one day it will expire. Then what is the path is slash you will give. That's all. So it will secure for HTTP only. Then HTTP means even you want to transfer a web page, then for storing the information the web page only we are using. So these arguments are mobile, name of the cookie is mobile, then value is mobile number, then the system time is taken. For one day you are keeping it as expire, not expire, that is expiry date is within one day. Then we are giving the path as simply slash. If you go for another folders and all, we are giving a slash. Then domain secure HTTP only, it is not given, it is taken as a default values. Then each echo cookie dot dollar cookie of mobile is set. So it will display for this number cookie is set. That's all. So the PHP tag starts like this question mark PHP and ends with question mark close parenthesis, that is close angular bracket we will use. So this is a method for defining the set. The set cookie function has 7 values. What are the 7 parameters? Name, it is used to specify the name of the cookie, then value, the value is the content of the information, then expiry. Expiry means the time that is taken from the GST time, GMT from our system time, it is used when it is expired. Then what is the path? Double slash or slash we will give normally for path. Then domain, this can be used to specify the name, domain name, and all cookies are valid for the host and domain which can be created by them. So only it is not given as any value. Then security, it is set as, if it is set as 1 means it is specified cookie should be sent only by secure transmission HTTP. If it is set as 0 means it is a regular. So secure means you are setting as 1 or 0. 0 means it can be sent as like a regular HTTP. So these are some of the arguments that is used here in the. Then how to modify a cookie? Already we set the mobile number, now you want to change the mobile number, then we will use modify cookie. So set again, use the same function set cookie only to modify, but the previous one can be changed from this mobile number. So the same syntax only, the only thing is there is no modify command, only using set cookie command you can change the previously existing mobile number to the new mobile number. That's all. How to delete a cookie? So how to delete a cookie means a set cookie time. Set cookie, the same thing is followed, but you are changing the mobile name, that is time minus 360. So the cookie is deleted from the current time, it is deleted. So the set cookie is the same function that is used for modifying, creating and deleting. The same work it is doing, but only the arguments we are changing. The arguments here is for set cookie we are giving the mobile number, time, and then for one day it is kept value. So you are specifying this to set. Then after that if you want to delete means time minus 3600 means cookie is deleted from the current date, it is deleted. Already you are given one day time, it is gone. So what we have to do is we have to delete. That's all.